गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई विल टीच क्लास 6 चैप्टर 7 दैट इज गेटिंग टू नो अबाउट प्लांट्स। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैड स्टडीड अबाउट द डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ प्लांट्स लाइक लीव्स स्टेम्स। इन टुडेज लेक्चर आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द अदर पार्ट ऑफ प्लांट दैट इज रूट्स एंड फ्लावर। Before going further, we have to understand about the two terms which are photosynthesis and transpiration. Photosynthesis is a phenomena by which a green plant prepares their food with the help of sunlight, carbon dioxide and water. As the surface of leaves contains small pores which is called stomata. So, stomata is helpful in exchange of gases, which means plants take carbon dioxide from the environment and giving out oxygen to the environment. In this way, the exchange of gases takes place. So, the photosynthesis is the process in which the preparation of food is take place on the surface of leaves. Next term is transpiration. Transpiration is the process during which release of water vapor through stomata, that is surface of leaves, take place. And here there is a suction force developed which helps to rinse water from roots to stem, and stem help to divert this water to other parts. So, transpiration can be easily seen by yourself, as in the morning you had seen a small droplets of water on the leaves. So, these small droplets, the water released from the surface of leaf, is due to the process transpiration. You can easily understand this phenomena at your home. From any green plants, cover the leaf of plant with the polythene bag and tie them. So be careful that the leaf does not pluck from the stem. So place this plant for 2 to 3 hours in the sunlight. After 2 to 3 hours, you can see a small droplets of water can easily seen on the inner side of polythene bag as well as on the surface of leaves. So in this way, we can say that transpiration is the release of water. So you can do the activity number 4 at your home. So the next part of plant is root. A root lies below the surface of the ground, that is under the soil. Its main function is to absorb minerals and other nutrients from the soil, which are helpful for the growth of plants. So there are two types of roots, that is tap root, number 2 is fibrous root. So tap root is the main root. It is large and fast growing root. So that main root contains the small roots as the branches of that main root. So that small root, as you easily seen here, are called lateral root. So for example, beetroot, carrot, radish are the examples which contain tap root. As you see a radish, it has main root, that is tap root, and small roots that are in the form of branches, that are lateral roots. Next is fibrous root. It has no main root. All are of same size as you are able to see. For example, spring onion, you see easily available in the market. The spring onion has fibrous root. So, in previous lecture, we had studied about the reticulate venation and parallel venation. So, reticulate venation is present in taproot, and the parallel venation is present in fibrous. So, here it is all about the roots. So, next part of plant is flowers. As you see, a flower has different parts like petal, stamen, sepal or pistil. So flower is the main reproductive part. part of the plant. So reproduction is take place from the flower. So there are different parts of flower. Number one is petal. As you see, it is a colored part. So mainly it covers the reproductive parts. So it is petal. So petal covers the reproductive part. So it is the reproductive part. So petal is colored. As you see, I have drawn a white color here. So here it is a petal. So number two is sepal. Sepal is green color part which enclose the bud. So it is a bud. So petal before opening, it is bud. So when it is open up, the different are called petals. So these green part is called sepal. So number three is stamen. As you see here, the yellow part is called stamen. So stamen consists of mainly two parts, that is anther and filament. So anther produces pollen grains. So pollen grains are helpful for reproduction. So filament is a spore which provides to the anther. So filament is a spore which provides to the anther. You can easily see here stamen. So stamen has two parts, that is anther and filament. So anther contains pollen grains. So next part is pistil. So pistil, you can see here, it is a central part. Here is the pistil. So pistil contains three parts, that is stigma, style, ovary. So pistil is the innermost part which produces ovules. So ovules are helpful in the production of new plant. So mainly stigma receives the pollen grain. So this part contains the pollen grains. So this stigma receives that pollen grains. Next, it is style. So style is the part which connects stigma and ovary. It is a straight tube which connects stigma and ovary. So ovary is a part, this part is called ovary, which produce ovules. Ovules are the eggs that produced by flower or that pistil. So ovary is a part that produce ovules. These are the ovules. So here it is the different parts of plant. So you can draw the structure of pistil, stamen and the parts of flower. So I will tag the workbook of this with this video. You can write the work in workbook. Thank you.